The National Mall is a place I run. The lawn and the trees, the gravel and the sun. Then one day when I was running like a missile, I came to a halt. I ran into the festival. Wales, that is. Folklife Fest.
Longest name in the world. 58 letters, I can barely keep it unfurled. If I try to speak it, I get my tongue all in a twirl. I'm glad it's a village, I would hate to name a baby boy or girl.
My friend Keith is a textile weaver. He takes the wool cut from a hand sheaver. He puts it in a machine and spins it like a dream to make a thread that's used.
Sound comes from the back of the throat. Got something stuck in the back of the throat.
My friend John plays a mean pig horn. It's made of elder wood and cow horn. Plays a hit tune whether short or long.
I wonder how it floats with a lot of slime barnacles. But then the whole history of the boat is just a true time miracle.
As quickly as possible. Use a knocker. Hit the salmon in the nets. A couple of knots on the fish, on the salmon's head.
My friend Trevor is the last full-time professional clog maker in Wales. He makes it by hand with leather, wood, and nails. He first takes sycamore and carves it to its right. That's why Welsh clog dancers can prance all night. Welsh slate is the strongest known to man. You cannot break it, slice it, or eat it with green eggs and ham. My lad Howard is making a slate pyramid stack. It weighs a ton, don't know how he's gonna get it back. I like to see Caitlin make traditional Welsh pottery. It's plain and simple, not too fancy, not too gaudy. Ceramic earthenware can serve you coffee or tea, so you can sit in the shade, take a sip, admire all life's glory. Stone wall was made by my friend Stuart, a great captain of Wales. He was quite a steward. Mine from the mountains of Wales, extracted from the deep quarry. If it's packed airtight, it will last a million years.
RuninDC, run.